The sight of the evil eye, long fields of barley and of rye, that clothe the world and meet the sky. Through the field the road run by, to many towered Camelot. And up and down the people go, gazing where the lilies blow. Round an island there below, the island of Shalott. Willows white and aspens quiver, little breezes dusk and shiver. Through the wave that runs forever, by the island in the river, flowing down. Four grey walls and four grey towers overlook a space of flowers, and the silent island bowers the Lady of Shalott. Only reapers reaping early in among the beaded barley hear a song that echoes cheerily from the river winding clearly down to towered Camelot. And by the moon the reaper weary, piling sheaves in uplands airy, listening whispers and hears the fairy, the Lady of Shalott. There she weaves by night and day a magic web with colors gay. She has heard a whisper say, a curse is on her if she stayed to look down to Camelot. She knows not what the curse may be, and so she weaves steadily. Little other care hath she, the Lady of Shalott. And moving through a mirror clear, there hangs before her all the year. Shadows of the world appear, there she sees the highway near, winding down. Sometimes through the mirror blue, the knights come riding two and two. She hath no loyal knight and true, the Lady of Shalott. But in a web she still delights to weave the mirror's magic sights. For often through the silent nights, you know, with plumes and with lights and music went to Camelot. When the moon was overhead, came two young lovers lately wed. I'm half sick of shadows, she said, the Lady.